Well, we've spent the last year and a half preparing a full necessity defense for this case and preparing all of the testimony, the witnesses, and the evidence for why there was a necessity to act to avert greater harm. The greater harm that this pipeline represented, both from its direct impacts and from the exacerbation of climate change. And we weren't able to present that full case, and so we basically just asked the judge to recognize that evidence was out there, that it's clear across our society the severity of climate change, the degree to which the government response has been a failure, and the degree to which regular folks like us have a necessity to act to prevent this harm, and for her to make that ruling with the authority that she had. So it was sort of a super condensed version of that defense that we were prepared to make, you know, a week-long trial or more with extensive evidence, and instead all of us combined took 2 minutes apiece, and we're really able to present, I think, a pretty coherent and comprehensive argument. You know, different folks focused on different pieces, which was really incredible to see. And I think we were able to make a case that was compelling enough for that judge. And hopefully the next time around, we'll get the opportunity to do that with the jury, and we'll keep fighting.
In terms of ruling that you are not guilty by necessity, is there any significance of the judge's ruling today?
Well, it's the first time I've won a necessity defense, so I'm pretty excited.
Yeah.
Even if it wasn't quite the trial that I wanted, you know, it's a good first step, and we'll keep fighting. Yeah.